Hello my loves, welcome back. Today's video is going to be all about child's pose. We will discuss how to do the pose, modifications, and variations of the pose. So although child's pose might seem like a very basic pose and kind of not that difficult to get wrong, then let's instead think about there being more comfort in the pose rather than finding a struggle or some discomfort. Let's find ways to get a little bit of peace and ease in our poses. So let's look at how to do child's pose. So come over onto all fours. As you find all fours, have the knees around hip distance apart. Just notice where the tops of the ankles, the tops of the feet connect to the floor. Draw the navel to the spine. Tuck in the chin and sit the hips back towards the heels. Resting the chest onto the thighs here. Let the forehead connect to the floor. The arms will reach back behind you. Then you'll find child's pose here. Supporting the torso on the thighs, letting the arms relax. Send the breath into the back body. Reaching the arms forward, come back up to all fours. So while that seems that there's not really a lot that you can modify for this pose, there really is, depending on what you have going on in your body. And the first thing I want to talk about is the knees. Quite a few people find that it's very tender on their knees, and there's a couple of ways that we can fix that. And this is where your trusty blanket comes in again. If you find that it's just a question of being on your knees that is just too tough for the front of your knees, bring a blanket underneath your knees and your shins and then sit back. So if that doesn't help, maybe it's not the connection of the shins and the knees to the floor. Maybe it's that you just can't sit back. There's not enough bend in your knee. Take the blanket, fold it up a little bit more, and then place it behind you. Bring it in nice and close to the knees. Again, knees around, hip distance apart, and then sit back. Just give your thighs something to sit on. Now another thing here is that you might not have enough ankle extension. If you come into child's pose and you have a space between the front of your ankle and the floor, you'll find yourself sitting here with a gap between you and the floor. And then the weight is pushed forward into your head because you can't rest on the thighs that well. And you may even find that your back kind of straightens out. If that's you, find again your blanket. Roll it up. Place it underneath your ankles and then sit back. Give yourself the support you need. All right, another variation of this pose involves the bolster. If you are the kind of person that you come onto all fours and you sit back, but the chest won't come down for whatever reason, then use a bolster, a pile of blankets, a pile of towels. Widen your knees a little bit, draw the bolster into you, and rest on the bolster. Okay, so what about the arms? Are the arms supposed to reach forward or are they supposed to reach back? So it's actually two different poses. As you sit into child's pose, traditional child's pose, forehead on the floor, arms reach back. In extended child's pose, the arms reach forward. One is not better than the other. One is not harder or more challenging than the other. If you're looking for more roundness in the upper back and the neck, then reach the arms back, tuck in the chin. If you're looking for a little more thoracic extension, then reach the arms forward. That might also give you some length into the lats. I personally find that this version, reaching the arms back, relaxes my shoulders, which I need after poses like dolphin and downward facing dog. You do you, which one feels right for you? Okay, the other thing that I want to talk about is the distance between the knees and the position of your lower back. Some people will want a nice wide-kneed base and some people won't. So, which one are you? I'm a narrow, I'm a legs together. How do you know which one is appropriate? This is how. If you come into child's pose and you find that perhaps there's too much body in the front and that you find yourself just kind of hanging, either use a bolster and rest your body on the bolster, or if you don't have a bolster, then widen your knees and let the body come down towards the floor so that you can rest your body on something. But there's always a but. If you're like me and you have a tight lower back, wide-legged child's pose might not be the best variation for you. Why not? Well, for people like me, I can come into a wide-legged child's pose, rest my chest down on the floor, tuck my chin in, and then still have some variation of an arch in my lower back. There's a very subtle arch now in my lower back, and the muscles are gripping. They're holding here. And if I palpate them, I can feel them working to hold me in place. It's not the best position for me or people like me with tight lower backs to be in. Instead, draw the knees in closer to one another and sit the hips back and rest there. And I always envision this like I'm going to cannonball into a swimming pool. I'm making myself as small as possible, drawing the tailbone down towards the heels, tucking in the chin, and pulling my navel up to the spine so I can lengthen out my lower back. This, for me, is child's pose. Try them all. See which one works for you. Okay, I hope that helped show you that there are a few different variations to child's pose. Although it's a beginner's pose and it seems like it's quite easy, there's a lot going on and there's a lot of variations depending on how your body feels in child's pose. It's not supposed to be a pose of effort or strain, so if you feel some tightness and you feel some gripping and holding of the muscles, then support. Support your body with blocks, with bolsters, with blankets, widening the knees or drawing the knees in together. All right, my loves, I hope that helps. I hope that you found some tips and tricks that you could use in child's pose. If you enjoyed this video, then give me a thumbs up and don't forget to subscribe if you're not already. And remember, my loves, that karma is only a bitch if you are. So be nice, be kind, and be the change that you want to see in the world.